Hello and welcome to a new mini squash. Today we are going to see another way to use squash datasets. We are going to use them as parameters for JUnit automated tests. First of all, we need a project in squash TM, and this project should be linked to at least one relevant Jenkins job. As you can see, we are in the test case workspace of squash TM, and here is a test case whose information and test steps have already been detailed. It has also been linked beforehand to a JUnit automated test. It fits our criteria. We are only going to add parameter. Let's go to the tab Parameters. We can see we have already added the parameter browser and two datasets, Chrome and Firefox. Now that our prep is done, we can get into the heart of the matter. How to use our new dataset for the JUnit automated tests. Let's switch to a Java class. We want the class which contains JUnit tests running on Selenium. Make sure that the test linked to our squash test is part of this class. For now, Selenium tests are only run on Firefox, as you can see it in the line here. But we don't want to be restricted to Firefox. That's why we've added the dataset earlier. And now this set, the browser snatcher, needs to become available via squashTM parameters. To do so, we are going to use squashTF to retrieve squashTM parameters and add a dependency to the service in the POM file of our project. So, in the POM, which holds JUnit tests, we paste the following lines. Now that the dependency is added, we need to import the squashTF service for parameters retrieval. Let's go back to our class to import this service. It is called tfParamService. And in the class, we write or paste the following line. Finally, we want to use this service to store the value of the browser, our squashTM dataset, in the variable param browser. We use the method getParam of squashTF service and use a character string as parameters. The string is made of ds followed by the name of the parameter chosen in squashTM. In this case, the parameter is browser. In the line I showed you before, we are going to write the following lines. And that's it. We have done everything we need to define our squashTM dataset as parameter for the automated JUnit test. Note that in this example, we use the parameter to define which browser to use for Selenium tests. But of course, you can exploit squash parameters any way you want according to your tests and needs. Now let's go back to squash to actually run the new version of our automated test. As usual, access the campaign workspace, create a new iteration, and add our test case to the new execution plan. Note that there should be two test cases to run here. Since the test case is run as many times as there are data items, it is run once with Firefox and another time with Chrome. Then click on the execution button to run the tests, and from here on, as you can see, it does the job automatically. Now you can see the window opens and the test is running on Chrome. Okay, the status is updated and the second one is running with Firefox. now it's okay, and the status is updated. Here we can see the updated status and date, and if we click on an execution line, we can access the detailed report on the results. Congratulations! You have successfully used the SquashTM dataset in a JUnit automated test. In this video, we did it for a JUnit test, but you can also use SquashTM datasets for robot framework scripts with the dedicated TF runner. You can find more tips for Squash on our dedicated YouTube channel. Feel free to subscribe to be updated with new videos. See you next time for another Minute Squash.